Right, hello everyone. I thought I'd treat myself to a Revell London Transport Bus, Routemaster, 124 scale. I used to travel with these when I was a schoolboy, and also later when I started work in London. And I thought they're great buses. First started travelling when about 56 years ago, I was about 11 or so. Travelled from Charlton to Plumstead in a 53, which was the longest bus route, I think, at the time. It might still be. And I think they used to use something like 40 53s going at any one time to keep the service, to keep the route going, so that, you know, it could be regular. I think about every 10 or 15 minutes. Anyway, the one I used to travel on was the one before this one. It's a Routemaster, but it was the slightly older shape. We had this open type radiator here with a little pressure cap on there. And I remember them overheating, and the driver would get out and they'd put a rag around it and undo it and let the steam out. That would have been the short one, because what happened was a change of regulation, and in the 50s they were allowed, the change of regulations, they're allowed to make vehicles over 30 foot on two rigid axles, they're allowed to make them a bit longer. So what they did, they lengthened the bus, and you can see this window here and here. That's the way it was lengthened, that section there. And then it was subsequently called, let's just point to it, RML, Routemaster Lengthened. Right. Anyway, they're all hop on, hop off buses. And I had a lot of fun hopping on as well. This was with my schoolmates. Especially jumping off when it's approaching traffic lights, or if I go around a bend corner or something, it's to jump off. You can get away jumping off at about 10 miles an hour, but any more, you could be for it. And also, when you jump off, you've got to face the direction of the bus, you know, otherwise you go straight over, straight on your back. That wasn't the idea, really. The idea of hopping on, hopping off was at bus stops, or just before and after. But when you're kids, you just do all sorts of stupid stuff. Winding these little windows down and throwing rubbish stuff out at girls below, you know, school girls below. But it's funny thing about this bus. F-reg, so that'd be about 68 or something. But if you look at the man there, he looks like his 1950s attire there. That's a Homburg hat. He looks 50s as well. God knows where he's come from. I can't see a bus conductor. And the driver, it looks like he's got a sweatshirt on. In those days, they would have wore uniforms. Anyways, and there's something else. I see Big Ben. Looks like some monstrosity in the back there. God knows what it is. It should be Westminster Abbey, but God knows what it is. But still. Anyway, that's enough of that. Now, next step is to open it up. So I'll tip it on its side and cut these security tabs. As you can see, I haven't done it yet. Oops. Should use them. That's one done. Should really use a craft knife. done. Perhaps use my fingernail. Another one down. This is certainly real time, all this. That's any one of you thinking, why did I do that before? Do this before. Right, that's that done. We've all got two, they're done. Just got this, just got this last one, I think. Christ. I hope the box is not empty. Right. Don't take too long, it'll take about 6 hours to load it. Load it on YouTube. Right, see what's inside it. You can see I haven't opened it before. I feel like a 10-year-old boy, you know, getting a Christmas present. Right. Now, open up. Right, here it goes. Right, now I think it's 391 parts or something. Right. Seats. Seats, seat frames, wheel hubs, trims, that one, more seats, seat frames, the rear top of the bus, looks like the inside of it, the back of the bus. Two parts. Oh, one looks like the back, and one is the front. Right, okay. The chassis floor. This is the inside lower deck. Inside. This looks like it could be the upper deck. Yeah. Okay. Tires. Rubber. They've got tread on the front. Yeah. Cross plies. Good. Good. That's good. Proper rubber. Right. Windows. Yeah. And more windows. Yeah. These windows look like they've got the actual the top windows. Now they have stainless steel around the top of the windows, fan lights, whatever you call them. So I suppose some silver have to be painted around or with some sort of pen. It's the front of the bus. Front cab. Engines. I think there's two types of engine that comes with it. So don't know why, but well, I know that there were probably several engines, but whether that was important enough to give you options, I don't know. There's looks like a fuel tank. Must be the God's. What is that? I don't know what it is. Well, it's parts of the differential prop shaft. whether that's, oh yeah, that's the prop shaft, so it's some sort of differential. God, there's so many parts. Right, further gets nitty gritty here. The side of the bus. Inside of the bus. Steps. There's steps. That's the outside. There's those small windows. Yeah, got very good feel to it actually. Can actually feel the rivets. Yeah, steering wheel. When does it stop? Instructions, which I'm hoping. Oh yeah, they look pretty good. Yeah, they do look good. It's a sort of it's level 5, which is Revell's highest skill level. So it's not for the faint-hearted. I'll probably bodge it up. These are the transfers for the seats. God, remember sitting on these. Victoria. Oh, this is option, different buses. I remember the, Blackfriars Bulls here, because I used to work around there, so I remember the 76. Yeah. Oh, here's the advertising decals. Jacob's crackers on one side and the London Transport. This one, which looks a bit weird. These. And Rod Stewart musical. Oh, what's that one? Victorian Palace. What? Which cross? Gardens. A garden set. I think some of these adverts are a bit iffy. Still. Not bad. Yeah, I suppose you soak them. That's really, this is something we've got to really be very careful with. Now, all these parts should come out of the plastic wrappers. Be washed in soapy water to get the fixative off, you know, from the moulds or whatever. Got the fixative. What is getting? Everything back. Yeah, and then release the agents. Moulds. Well, that's it. I'll put it back properly later. Oh, not bad. Well, this is part one. Bit like there might be part 2, 3, 4, or it might just be part 1. Anyway, thanks for watching.